right, guys, first and foremost, I want to welcome you. Appreciate you guys coming in. Today, we're just going to go over something very simple, the recruiting basics for our host program, okay? What we're going to go over today is we're going to first and foremost talk about NCAA rules. That's the most important thing we do, is roles and responsibilities that you guys will have, and also an example of our itinerary, which I gave you guys when you walked in. Don't look at it now, just wait, okay? And then we'll do a facility tour at the end, okay? Guys, the simple thing to ask yourself is, why do we have recruiting rules? You know, back in the day, it was just kind of the wild, wild west, pay money, do whatever you had to, and all those things. But we have recruiting rules to promote equity among the member institutions in the recruitment of prospects. Ultimately, when you think about the SEC, which we are, they have way more, you know, I guess money, and the budget's way higher. It wouldn't be fair for the SEC to compete with, let's say, a MAC team, for example, because of the amount of money. So what's important is that we have equity throughout the Division I schools. Another thing, talking about the actual student-athlete, is to shield prospects from undue pressures that may interfere with scholastic or athletic interests. I mean, I think that kind of speaks for itself. Guys, you know how much pressure on these kids now. I mean, my Lord, the way recruiting's blown up, there's websites, you got 24/7 Rivals, you know, Scout, all those different things, and they're constantly getting stuff with the Twitter age, man. It's just unbelievable, okay? What is the definition of recruitment? You guys will see a lot of NCAA bylaws. We get a huge manual, which I'll give you guys next time. I want you guys to go through that, okay? Basically, the definition of a recruit or recruitment is any solicitation of a prospect or prospect's relatives by an institutional staff member, me, for example, you guys, for example, okay, or a booster for the purpose of securing the prospect's enrollment and participation in the institution's athletic program. In this case, guys, we're obviously talking about football, okay? What is the definition of a prospective student-athlete? A student-athlete is simply this. A student has began classes in the ninth grade, okay, or a student who has not yet started classes for the ninth grade, but to whom the institution provides financial assistance or other benefits that it does not provide to the general student body. I can remember back a few years ago when I was coaching junior college ball, there's a kid that's actually at Alabama now. His name's Dylan Moses. He was an eighth grader, and Alabama actually offered him. So at that point, he became a recruited player because in the eighth grade, he was being recruited. Don't see that a whole lot, but it's becoming more and more common. I remember a few years ago, USC offered a kid that was a seventh grade quarterback, which is insane, who ended up playing receiver. Now he's at West Virginia. I believe his name's David Sills. Okay. An individual remains a prospect until he or she officially registers and enrolls full-time and attends classes at a four-year institution. Not part-time. You have to have at least 12 hours to be a legal student-athlete, I guess. Participates in a regular squad practice or competes at a four-year institution. The moment we step on the field in a practice setting, their clock starts, okay? Officially registers, enrolls, attends classes during the summer prior to initial enrollment, and receives athletics financial aid, okay? And also reports to an institutional orientation session that is open to all incoming students within 14. You guys can read all that, man. I feel like I'm just repeating stuff over and over. Okay, good. What triggers recruitment? Providing a prospect with an official visit. And we'll get into official visits later. Right now, we're kind of living in the unofficial world. But arranging an in-person, off-campus encounter with a prospect, with a prospect or a relative. Guys, you really can't have off-campus contact with the recruit unless it's during a certain period, okay, during his recruitment. Initiating or arranging a telephone contact with the prospect or relatives on more than one occasion, okay, and issuing a national letter of intent, which is ultimately what they sign on what's known as National Signing Day. Accountable football coaches. Only those coaches who have been certified may contact or evaluate any prospective student athletes off campus. Okay? You guys cannot meet with these kids off campus. I want to be very, very clear that any off campus issues or meeting up with these people off campus, it's illegal, okay, and you'll be fired immediately. That's period, end of discussion, that's not up for debate. Okay? Certification must occur on an annual basis and shall include a requirement that the coaches shall have passed a standardized national test developed by the NCAA, and a lot of that's just other jargon. Every year, guys, usually in July, I have to take a test. It's about 30 questions, takes about an hour, where I have to pass an NCAA certification test for recruiting and coaching, okay? It's tough, but the rules are there for a reason, all right? And some of our accountable coaches on our staff, Coach Smart, Coach Coley, Coach Tucker, Coach Pittman, Coach Chaney, Schumann, McGee, Scherer, Beamer, Coach Scott, Coach Davis, Coach Tillman, Coach Stone, and your favorite coach, Coach Piegler. All right. All right. Contacts, guys. Contacts a little different in different phases. Okay. A contact is any face-to-face encounter with a prospect or relative by an institutional staff member or booster during which any dialogue occurs in excess of an exchange of a greeting. Okay. Face-to-face contact, contact. Period. That easy to say. Only accountable coaches, 9 assistant coaches, and 1 head coach are allowed to have contact with recruits off campus. So I just talked about accountable coaches on the last slide. I am accountable coach in terms of recruiting and making the phone calls and evaluating, but I cannot have off-campus contact with any of these prospects. That's against the rules, okay? Just want to make that clear once again. Publicity, okay? This is kind of an interesting thing because now you're starting to see all these different Twitter deals and all these graphics. That's kind of become the name of the game. Publicity. Before a prospect signs an NLI or an institution's written offer of admission or financial aid, or before the institution receives his financial deposit in response to his offer, you cannot comment on this student athlete. That is an NCAA violation. It happened a few years ago that I can remember. A kid told a school he was going to sign. They released it, which became an NCAA violation. Until he puts pen to paper, or she puts pen to paper, it is a violation to report that they have committed to your school. Now, can you send an edit out to them that says committed, and they put it out? Yes, but you as the University of Georgia cannot do that. So if you see that, and it's on Georgia Football, report it immediately, guys, because we got to get it down, then we got to report it to compliance, okay? A lot of times people try to hide things in compliance. I've always felt like if you're honest and straightforward, tell the truth, and present that to those guys, they will do everything they can to try to help you within the scope of the rules, obviously. Okay, and I've kind of already mentioned those. You guys can read through it. I'll give you a few seconds here to read through it. You give me the head nod when you're ready, okay? All right, cool. Dead period. No in-person, on- or off-campus contacts or evaluations permitted. No complimentary tickets. Phone calls and written correspondence are permissible only by accountable coaches. Dead period, guys. The time that stands out to me for the dead period is right after the national championship game during the coaches' convention. You can talk to them and all that stuff, but in person, on campus, completely illegal. You cannot have them on your campus during the dead period. That's a pretty easy one, guys. I mean, there's a reason it's called, you know, the dead period. Official visits and unofficial visits, which is where you guys are really going to come up big for us, because ultimately, and I'll get into more of your roles and responsibilities, but it's about having a genuine, authentic presentation for these guys and everything we do, okay? An official visit is a campus visit paid in whole or in part by the University of Georgia. It can only be 48 hours. So from the moment they step foot on campus, the clock starts, okay? An unofficial visit is a campus visit that is paid entirely by the prospect. You know, like I just said, official visits, we pay for their meals. When they come on unofficial visits, we have to charge them whatever it costs. Like for a meal, for example, I think it's like 10 bucks. You know, we change it based on what's happening and how much it actually costs. And it must take place on campus or within 1 mile off campus. All right, let's get into that 48-hour period here, that window. I've already mentioned that it starts as soon as they arrive on the campus, and it does not include transportation. Okay, so, you know, we can set, a lot of times what a lot of schools will do, quite honestly, is they'll go pick the prospect up in a car and drive them over so they can spend more time. I think that's kind of a, I was about to say a bad word, I'm not going to do that. That's kind of a way to try to get around the rules, guys. It's probably not right, but a lot of people do it. Okay? Official visit, the meals. 3 meals per day, and I take advantage of them, as you can tell by this great body. Don't laugh. Thank you. All right. 3 meals per day for the prospect and the parents, okay? Spouse or children. I haven't really ran around the spouse or the children part because you're usually dealing with really young kids, 17, 18 years old, and an additional snack is permissible. Okay, official visit. Talking about the lodging. It must take place within a 30-mile radius of the campus. We can't take a kid to Atlanta. That's against the rules. Okay, scale comparable to that of a normal student life with no special accessories, okay? Guys, just give them a nice hotel room. It's that simple. It's not anything overly complicated. And it's only for the prospect and the parents. If they want to bring 75 other people, we can't pay for it, and they got to just get together in one big room, okay? Activities during the official visit, okay? This is really important, guys, because I can think of a case where Washington got in trouble for this a few years ago, okay? An institution may not arrange miscellaneous personalized recruiting aids, aka jerseys, personalized scoreboard presentations. I can remember, like I said, at Washington a few years ago, they actually ran out of the smoke and all those things, which is highly illegal. You can't do that. That's simulating a game day environment, and we can't do that, okay? That's something. Personalized recruiting aids include any decorative items and special additions to any location the prospect will visit. You know, that's pretty simple. I mean, I think you guys can kind of understand that by reading through it. Okay, activities during an unofficial visit. Again, what is different about an unofficial visit? We can't pay for it. Okay, same rules. Okay, we can't have all these personalized things and all that stuff. I mean, it's really a lot of the same rules, except we can't pay for anything. Okay. Academic fraud, okay? This is one that's pretty obvious for you guys deal with it every day. You hear about it at the beginning of the semester with your teachers. It won't be tolerated. Same thing with football. Each student athlete's classwork comes from his or her own efforts and must be comprised of his or her own thoughts and words. Man, I'm struggling right now, man. You know, there's a little Powerade here. You're not allowed to assist a student athlete with any class assignment. But you know, I'm going to be honest, the first point here, including proofreading, editing, and typing a paper, I get it in terms of not helping kids, but I think we should be able to proofread and help them. If a kid comes to you and asks for your help, we should be, but we're not. So again, another non-negotiable thing, guys. Confidentiality. This is probably the biggest thing with every one of you guys, man. You have got to keep all the information you hear in these walls. Because, guys, people will do anything to know what's going on in Georgia football right now, okay? There are so many people that will text me, hey, what are you hearing on this, hearing on that? I say, hearing the same thing you are. You know, I don't give them a chance. I don't play in that world. You can't release any information about their health and especially injuries. I know I say including, but especially injuries, guys. That gives the opponent an advantage over us, okay? You guys are going to be privy to information you didn't even know existed while working here, okay? You can't make comments to the media. I think that's pretty self-explanatory. Guys, period. If I catch on the message boards and on Rivals, you're done. Another non-negotiable. Okay, role and responsibility. I think I want everybody to take a chance, just read through this. As a student host, you're responsible for serving as a total advocate of not only our program or football program, but the University of Georgia, okay? You are always a representative of our coaching staff, our players, and our university, okay? And with that, we have core values, authenticity, which I think is pretty. We want you to tell the truth, guys, because ultimately, if they show up here and we've lied to them, that becomes an issue, and it just rolls downhill constantly. It'll become a culture issue. You'll have guys, well, they lied to me in recruiting, blah, blah, blah. We don't want that. We're authentic. It's hard as hell to play here. It really is. It's not easy. Coach Smart's hard on us, but he expects excellence in all phases. We expect that from you guys, okay? Community, integrity, and leadership. Integrity is the one that really stands out to me, guys. Be truthful. Don't bend the rules, because it's just not worth it. All right, and some of the things, we'll have Thursday meetings before every home game, okay? The spring game, official and unofficial visits, and I got cut off there, and our junior days, okay, which we'll get into later on. It's not really that important today. Here's an example of our recruiting itinerary, guys, which I gave you guys when you walked in. Okay, this is a game day from earlier this season, okay, for a night game, okay? We like to start with you guys getting here about 1 o'clock. I know some of you will be eager, especially early in the season, to come in early and all that good stuff. Food's getting ready for everybody. You guys get a nice meal. And then we'll set up and we'll go through all that here in a few minutes, guys, out in the Smith Lobby entrance. Registration begins. Okay, like I told you guys earlier, like we're charging $10 for lunch and we'll give snacks at halftime, which are $4. So $14 for these guys to come on campus. And if they choose not to eat, they don't eat. I mean, it's that simple. They don't pay. We'll have lunch and games. You know, I kind of excel at that dang, what's the ball called? Ladder ball and cornhole and all that fun stuff. All right, and then we'll have a pregame meal for the coaches, which, again, I'm a big fan of. We'll arrive in the indoor around 4. Coach Smart will come in and talk. We'll do a little video. And then we have to leave, but you guys will still be there. This is where you guys are critical, man. You'll be there while we're in there getting ready, having our last walkthrough before we go to the game. You guys will load up the bus, head over, okay? And then you'll get to see the dog walk. Everybody will dress up in a nice suit. We'll take you guys to see a highlight video on the tape center or the tape theater, okay? And then we'll get you guys on the sideline for the game. You'll get to see all that. Coaches will come meet with all the players and all that fun stuff. You guys, again, just keeping them entertained, guys. And we'll get into all that stuff more. And then go to the seats. We'll kick somebody's tail. And then you come to Letterman's Club for snack. And then after the game, come see us, and then we'll dismiss you. Guys, we're going to come through these doors when the prospects get in here. And they're going to come. They're going to fill out some paperwork. We go A through L, M through Z. Okay, when they get in, they will fill out their unofficial visit forms. They will fill out their prospect cards. We'll give them a lanyard and all that good stuff. And we'll kind of walk them through the general process to start. All right, so I'm going to show you guys where we're going to meet. We're going to go to the next room. They'll walk down this hall, guys, after they fill all that stuff out. They'll come in here, guys, and they will very simply, they will pay for the, come on in, you come on in. We'll have tables set up, guys, right here, and they're just simply gonna pay. They're gonna pay for their meals, okay, and we'll put a sticker on their lanyard and pay that $4, okay, right here. And we'll just walk through. They'll come around. They would go through that door over there, but we'll just walk out here, okay. And then this is where they're gonna meet you guys, their host. Okay, and then we'll start taking them around, showing them around. Okay, cool. First thing we're going to do is we're going to height and weight them, take them through here. Oh, I got fired. Might actually be open. There we go. Come on in. It's obviously the weight room. They'll ask questions and all that good stuff. You can present that to them. We've got some things set up in here, guys, a little height and weight in the corner. A lot of times our strength coaches will be in here, and again, they'll ask questions. We'll tell them all about being Olympic style. We'll get into a little bit more of that later about what we actually do within the program. They're good, guys. So we'll height and weight them right here. You'll see the setup. They got a good feel for it. All right. You got to tell them the information. We'll weigh them. Over here, it's not set up right now, guys, but we'll get to it. All right, guys, one thing we also do is we're going to check their wingspan. Okay, we're getting their hand sizes. You guys don't have to worry about that, but they'll be asking questions. What exactly are we doing? And also over here, every day after practice, they're going to have some form of shake. Now, obviously, this week we're getting ready to play Kentucky. We talk about out-recovering our opponents. So we got different types of shakes we got. You know, we got things for weight gain. Obviously, these smoothies down here on the bottom, those are more for weight gain. And then we always have personalized shakes ready to go for them after the game. We've got several vitamins and all that type of stuff. So, here we got the athletic training room. You know, Ron Corson is one of the best in the country. Make sure you mention that, guys. He is a Hall of Famer, okay? Really sell that because that's one of the best things about our program, okay? In terms of what we provide, we've got concussion test labs and all that good stuff. Ron is one of the guys that's kind of known throughout the country as being cutting edge. He's one of the first ones that really started taking the concussion testing very seriously. Now you're hearing about all these CTE things in the NFL. We've been doing that for a long time here. Ron actually has a kid on the team, so they're going to get that type of, you know, I guess the best way to put it, they're going to have quality care from a father-type figure constantly. Come on through, Saul. That's fine. Okay. Let's give a little presentation to our new host. And, all right, so Also, in the back, guys, we've got hydro tubs and all those good things. We've got all the cutting-edge equipment and all that stuff. We've got 4 full-time athletic trainers on staff along with Ron. And really and truly, guys, the only thing we don't do here and take care of is surgery. We've got everything you need here. And another thing I think that's really important is all the former players come back here, because Ron's one of the best in the country, like we talked about. So make sure we really sell that. You know, Todd Gurley was in here right before the season getting extra work done, just cleaning his body up and making sure he was ready to go for fall camp. All right, guys, this is our team meeting room. As you look around, you'll see a lot of history, obviously. Georgia's been really good for a long, long time here. To our left here, you'll see the conference champions, which I think is really important. You know, 2005 is the last time a conference championship's been won here. Hopefully we can put one on the wall here in a few weeks. We'll see what happens. You know, we got some signs. We've got more than enough room in here to fit all of our players. SEC East champions, last time it happened was 2012. Oh wait, something changed, 2017. Okay, guys. All right, one thing also, guys, Coach Smart does all of his Monday press conferences in here. We'll field the media and all that type of thing. And one thing that we do a really good job of, I've been in a lot of different places, and honestly, probably one of the best things we do here is we get guest speakers in constantly, because, you know, they hear the message from Coach Smart and us all the time, but sometimes it's nice to hear an outsider come in and give the same message. You know, usually sometimes it's got a religious, you know, tone to it. It's also got like a toughness. We've had Rangers, Army Rangers come in, Navy SEALs, ministers. We had Chris Tucker from Friday come in and talk recently. So we've had a lot of people come in and give great messages to our guys, and they eat that stuff up. All right, guys, right behind me here is our locker room. You guys can get a little peek at it here in a little bit. Players are in there changing right now, so you guys need to be aware of the things that are in there. We got like basketball, we got a pool table, a couple arcade games, that type of thing for them to play. Okay, let's go this way. Okay, guys, just let Lady walk through here. Just want to show you guys a couple of our position meeting rooms. This is where the outside linebackers meet. Coach Cheryl will get the guys in there. Inside linebackers with Coach Schumann. See if hopefully nobody's in here. I'll show you guys what it looks like inside. It's just a smaller deal. You know, it's inside linebackers. We only carry about 8 on scholarship, so it's not really a need for a huge room. Okay. On the top again. All right, guys. This is kind of our new deal, man. The indoor athletic facility. This is really as good as there is in the country. You know, a lot of people beat us up facility-wise on a lot of things, but they can't beat us up on this. This is brand new. It's as big as any in the country. Got a huge big board in the middle. We got a lot of our history. Got our SEC championships. If you look where the SEC championships are here on the right side here, this is where we're going to set up our games for the guys whenever they come in on their unofficial business and that type of thing. As you make your way to the left over my shoulder here, this is where we're going to set the food up. Kind of right around the G. We'll have tables set up and we'll have barbecue of some sort. Again, more history. Commit to the G, one of our big slogans at our university. And then our national championships in 1942 and 1980. Okay. Again, guys, there's more than enough room. We actually practice here every Thursday. So, you know, obviously we get offense, defense. We get 120 guys in here in practice on Thursday, and it's really good, and it's actually more than enough room. It's kind of shocking. You think whenever you're out there at a practice field, you see how big and how vast everything seems. It seems like whenever you get inside, you'll say, well, dang, that ain't enough room, but it's plenty of room because we also have the track on the backside if we need to do extra stuff O-line-wise and that type of thing. So, cool.